This weekend, the devs turned off Bloodlust as an experiment. An interesting move, as the community has been complaining a lot recently about killers such as the Spirit being too OP, and once again, rather than listening to that, they decided to go in a bit of a different direction. And on the live server too? If only they had some sort of public test server available for things like this. What's followed has been an interesting weekend, to say the least. I played a few games with my brother offstream over the weekend, and in both games, we found killers at green to red ranks that really struggled to be effective. It may just be that they were bad killers, but this is something that others are finding too. If you don't know, Bloodlust gives killers a movement speed boost in a chase and stacks up to 3 times. It resets when you hit a survivor or you break a pallet and won't charge when using your power or when a survivor is walking. All in all, after 45 seconds, you gain a speed boost of plus 0.6 meters per second, which is a 12.5% speed boost compared to survivor speed. Still doing numbers here on the Pepsi YouTube channel. Still doing numbers. Okay, so arguments for and against, I guess. Some survivors are really freaking good, such as me. When will you learn? Oh, shit. There's an age limit on sub buying. Oh, dearie me.
I mean, that was a pretty good move in this situation. And so was that. God dang. Try it. Oh,
and it's easier to be a survivor in a chase than a killer, as the killer has to plan around the various obstacles that serves can utilize. I am not going to debate whether or not the game is survivor-sided or killer-sided. It's survivor-sided. It is a survivor-sided game. It's so much easier to be a survivor in this game than it is to be a killer. I refuse. If you disagree with me, there is not a chance in hell that you're red ranks. Not a chance in hell. But Bloodlust gives an advantage to killers who make mistakes and do poorly in chases. It might even be a reason why so many bad killers are such high ranks. You know who you are. Removing it means that killers can't rely on just keeping track of a survivor until their crazy speed boost kicks in, and they actually have to learn how pallets and windows and tiles work. It levels the playing field a bit and makes chases a more objective test of skill rather than a waiting game. So, I don't know how I feel about it. I don't know how I feel about it, personally. On the one hand, it's a tool for killers to actually catch up with survivors, and removing that passive tool from a killer's repertoire feels really strange. All it is doing is making it harder for killers to kill. But on the other hand, if you're relying on Bloodlust to get kills, then you're not a very good killer anyway, right? I am not a very good killer. Sometimes I win chases by getting to Bloodlust 1, sometimes Bloodlust 2. Very, very rarely do I find myself getting to Bloodlust 3. Because you're kicking pallets, you're lunging, you're making attempts to actually hit the survivor, and if you're not, then you're clearly doing something wrong. Removing Bloodlust was a surprising move from a company that runs a game with many, 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 so freaking many issues and community complaints, and doesn't really address a single one of them. But the benefit is that they've proven that they're willing to change up a fundamental aspect of the game to see whether or not it improves things. And in my mind, that's a big deal and is only a positive. There isn't really any news after this. I think Bloodlust is now back on, but they are yet to publish their findings. I might make a follow-up video to this when they do, but the fate of Bloodlust remains unknown. There have been some suggestions that the ability should become a perk, meaning that low rank or poor killers that rely on it could still use it and use it effectively. I like that idea. That's a cool idea. It would need to be available for every single killer. If they bring out a new killer and then introduce Bloodlust as a perk, that would suck. I would also perhaps suggest making the timer shorter so that it's not just like stripping away a passive ability and then selling it back to us with blood points. It's actually like an improvement. I don't know. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments and join me on Twitch every single day at 8 p.m. Apart from weekends. I don't stream on weekends. Maybe I should start streaming on weekends.